Good morning, dear children. Welcome you all in Sakshi Gopala's chemistry classes. Dear children, we have already dealt with three sets governing MCQs from chapter Basic Concepts in Organic Chemistry. Now in this video class, I am moving ahead with set number 4. See, the very first question which we have is, I am reading out the question. You can note it down. Distillation under reduced pressure is used to purify those liquids which have very low boiling point, are volatile, have high boiling points and which decomposes below their boiling points, and the last option is large difference in their boiling points. So children, in this question pucha hai ki distillation under reduced pressure is used for which type of liquids. We very well know this answer, that we use when the liquids, they have very high boiling points, right? When the liquids, they have the very high boiling points, and that too they decomposes below their boiling points. Those kinds of liquid, they are purified by using distillation under reduced pressure. So the correct answer is answer number C. Now we have the next question. See, it is asked here, separation of two substances by crystallization depends upon their differences in, option A is density, solubility, melting point and boiling point. So dear children, we know that the process of crystallization is based on the principle of solubility. The two substances, they differ in the solubility, and hence for that kind of separation we use crystallization. So the correct answer is answer B. Now see, we have the next question. Steam distillation is used for substances, right? And here are the given four options. So children, steam distillation kab use kiya jata hai? When the substance which is needed to purify, they are what? They are steam volatile as well as insoluble in water. So we use, the correct answer is answer A. We use steam distillation when the substances are steam volatile as well as insoluble in water. The next question, see, it is asked in the question, freshly prepared solution of sodium nitroprusside, right? Freshly prepared solution of what? Sodium nitroprusside, right? That is added to sodium extract. Appearance of a deep violet color, it indicates the presence of. Question ne pucha gaya hai, when you add the freshly prepared solution of what, children? Sodium nitroprusside, right? To sodium extract. Now, if there comes the deep violet color, what it indicates? It indicates the presence of sulfur. So, the correct answer is B, sulfur. Now children, let us understand what is that complex formation which brings the deep violet color. Now children, let us understand the chemistry. What is that complex ion formation which gives the violet color? See, we have added sodium nitroprusside in sodium extract. In Lesenges extract, when you prepare the Lesenges extract, you test the various elements present in that organic compound. Say for example, you check for the nitrogen, phosphorus, halogen, then sulfur, right? Now see, in your Lesenges extract, if there is a presence of sulfur, so this is your Lesenges extract organic compound in which sulfur is present. Now what happened? When you add a sodium nitroprusside, right? What is the formula for sodium nitroprusside? See, this is sodium nitroprusside, Na2, then the complex bracket, it is FeCl5, then NO. Right, students, this is called as sodium nitroprusside. Then how it react with the Na2S, means sulfur present in the organic compound, it is going to form Na4FeCN5NOS, right? And this complex brings the deep violet color, right? It is called as sodium thionitroprusside. Okay, I hope this question is clear to you. Now here we have the next question with us. See, the blue compound which is formed in the positive test for nitrogen with Lasagne solution of an organic compound. Right, you have to tell that. Question mein pucha ye hai ki when you prepare the Lasagne extract, okay, and if there comes the conformation of nitrogen, what is that complex which gives the blue color? Okay, so these are the given options. So my dear children, the correct answer is answer number D, Fe4, then in the complex there is FeCN6, then whole thrice. Right children, now let us understand the chemistry, how this complex is formed, which give the conformation, or you can say the positive test for nitrogen. Now children, let us understand the mechanism of how the blue color ion is formed. See, what you do, the very first step of this reaction is you boil the sodium extract with iron 2 sulfate. Iron 2 sulfate is FeSO4 thrice. Right children, that means iron is present in the +2 oxidation state. Now in the sodium extract, obviously we know that if it gives the conformation of nitrogen, that it means it has nitrogen is present in the organic compound, and when it react with the sodium extract, you know what it forms? Sodium cyanide. So in this, the very first reaction, this is cyanide ion. I'm not mentioning the sodium plus ion, okay? I'm only showing the reaction of cyanide ion, okay? Because actually the cyanide ion takes place in the reaction step. Now see, the cyanide ion, it react with the Fe2+, right? This Fe2+, we get it from the iron 2 sulfate. Now how the reaction proceeds? This is the formation of a complex ion, FeCN6. Then whole bracket, this is 4 minus. Why? Because we have 6 minus plus 2 plus, we get minus 4. Now see, what is the name of this complex? This is called as hexacyano, because there are 6 atoms of cyano. Then ferric to iron that is present in the +2 oxidation state. Now see children, there is a second step which we are going to proceed with, heating this complex in presence of concentrated H2SO4, that is concentrated sulfuric acid. Now what is the function of sulfuric acid? It will convert the ferrous ion, few of the ferrous ion, into ferric ion. See, Fe2+, that is converted in Fe3+, that is the ferric form. Now what happened? This ferric ion, it react with this complex. Complex which is formed in the step number 1. So see the reaction. Here we have the ferric ion Fe3+. When it react with the complex FeCN6, that hold 4-, right? What it form? We already know that some of the ferrous ion that is converted in a ferric ion. Right? Now we get a complex in which the iron is present in both the state, in ferrous as well as in the ferric form. So see, we get a complex Fe4. This Fe4 is present in a +3 form, that is in the ferric form, okay, iron 3. Now FeCN6, then whole thrice. Right children, the name is the iron 3, that means I'm talking about this iron which is present in the +3 state. Then hexacyano, ferrate, this iron that is present in the +2 state. So this complex gives the blue color, okay, which confirms the presence of nitrogen in the organic compound. I hope the reaction which is the mechanism of this reaction is clear to you. Now we are having the next question. See what is asked in this question. In Lasagne test for nitrogen, sulfur as well as halogen, The organic compound is, given options are fused with sodium, dissolved with sodamide, extracted with sodamide, and D option is fused with calcium. इसमें पूछा है, when you prepare the lysine extract, okay, the organic compound is fused with what? Okay, so the correct answer is, the organic compound is fused with sodium. Correct answer is answer number A. Now, dear children, we have the next question. See what is asked here. In Kisdall's method, right? We know the Kisdall's method, that is the quantitative method to determine the percentage of nitrogen present in an organic compound. Right, children? So, let us read the question. In Kisdall's method of estimation of nitrogen, nitrogen is quantitatively converted to ammonium sulfate. This is the first step. Now, what is written? It is then treated with standard solution of alkali. See, alkali is any NaOH or a KOH. Basically, alkali is a base. Okay. Now, the nitrogen present is estimated as. This is a question about the Kisdall's method of estimation of nitrogen. So, we know that in the Kisdall's method, okay, the very first step, the nitrogen which is present, that is converted into what? Ammonium sulfate. Now, what we will do with that ammonium sulfate? We treat it with any alkali. Now, the nitrogen which is present, that is liberated as a ammonia gas. Now, when we treat that ammonia gas with H2SO4, with sulfuric acid, we can actually get the percentage of nitrogen. So, the nitrogen which is present, that is liberated as a ammonia gas. So, the correct answer is answer C, ammonia gas. Now, see children, in this question, this is again a matched up of question. See, in the column 1, it is given the estimation of the various elements, right? And in the second column, it is given the formulae. You have to match both of this. See, first category is carbon. We used to measure the carbon in terms of the carbon dioxide. Now, students, first of all, see, the common part in these formulas is W1 upon W into 100. So, what is W1 in each case is the weight of the term in which the given element is estimated. Now, W is the weight of organic compound. Now, see, moving with the first option, carbon. Carbon, it is measured as carbon dioxide. Now, see, here in the fourth option, this fifth one, see, weight of carbon, that is 12 upon 44, that is the weight of carbon dioxide. Now, W1 here, it is the weight of carbon dioxide upon W, weight of organic compound into 100. So, this is 1. This is matched with the 1. Okay. Carbon. Now, coming with the nitrogen. We know that the nitrogen that is measured as volume of nitrogen at STP, that is standard temperature and pressure. Now, see in this fourth option, we have N2, that is weight of N2, that is 28 upon 22400 into volume of nitrogen at STP upon weight of organic compound into 100. So, this is for the category of nitrogen, right? Now, coming to the bromine, right? See the option number 1. Bromine, the weight of bromine is 80 and it is estimated as AgBr. So, weight of AgBr, that is 188. Now, here again, here W1 upon W into 100. So, this is the case of bromine 3, right? Bromine. Now come to the category of sulfur. Sulfur, that is C option number 3. Weight of sulfur, that is 32 and it is estimated as barium sulfate. Barium sulfate weight is 233 into W1 upon W into 100. This is for sulfur, right? Now the rest is phosphorus. Phosphorus, the weight of two atoms of phosphorus, okay, that is 62. Now what is this 222? That is, it is measured in terms of Mg2P2O7, right? It is measured in terms of Mg2P2O7. So here we are considering the two atoms of phosphorus. So we are taking 31 into 2, that is 62, upon 222, this is the molecular weight of Mg2P2O7 into W1 upon W into 100. Children, I hope this question is clear to you. Now the next question, this is again a match type of question. See what is given in the column 1, that is the various test, okay, which is used for the estimation of different elements, and in the column 2 it is given the various elements and you have to match these. The very first which we have is a Bellestein test. We very well know that the Bellestein test, that is used for the halogens, and in this category chlorine is given. So the very first option, you can match it with the chlorine, right? Bellestein test is used for detection of chlorine. Now comes sodium nitroprusside. It is matched with the sulfur. Why? In the Lesenges extract, when you add sodium nitroprusside to the extract, okay, it forms the presence of sulfur by forming the complex ion which is violet in color. What is the name of that complex ion? It is sodium thionitroprusside. So it confirms the presence of sulfur. Now Liebig method, that is used for the carbon. Liebig method is used for the carbon. Now very well, the last one is the Kisdahl's method. Kisdahl's method is used for the nitrogen estimation. Okay, so I hope this question is clear. So see the next question, that is, this is the last question of the series. 2.18 gram of organic compound, right, containing sulfur, it produces 1.02 gram of barium sulfate. The percentage of the sulfur you have to calculate. Dear students, just now we have learned that the percentage of sulfur is estimated in the form of the barium sulfate. So let us see how to calculate this. Right, see, first of all, what is given in the question? The very first thing, 2.18 gram of the organic compound. So here the weight of the organic compound is given as 2.18 gram, right? Now what is given? See, here containing sulfur produces 1.02 gram of the barium sulfate. Now sulfur, that is estimated in terms of barium sulfate. So W1, that is 1.02 grams, right? Now the percentage of sulfur, that is, you know the formula, weight of the sulfur, that is 32 upon, what is the molecular weight of barium sulfate? That is 233 multiplied by W1, that is 1.02, divided by weight of the organic compound, that is 2.18, now multiplied by 100 to get the percentage. You will get, when you solve this answer, you will get the answer as 6.42%, right? So this is the percent of sulfur present in the given organic compound. I hope, children, this question is clear to you.